Hi there, my name is AJ Cordeiro, and today we're going to be looking at the Canon XA-10 camera system. The XA-10 is a pretty typical device that you'll find for journalism reporting. It produces broadcast quality results and is great for run and gun shooting. Many of the skills you'll learn on the XA-10 are easily transferable, so when you work at a place that doesn't use this particular device, you'll have the majority of good practices already built in, and it will simply be a matter of learning the menu system so you can quickly get up and running. The XA-10 allows you to record ENG or electronic news gathering work in a compact form without sacrificing on the quality. It's got a 1920 by 1080 CMOS sensor that does a great job capturing most elements you would find in news packages. It's got a built-in viewfinder, but also has a fold-up LCD display which you can use for monitoring. It also allows you to play with the frame rate of your footage, shifting between 60 interlaced frames per second to 24 and 30 progressive frames per second. It's great for multicam shoots, documentary work, and video segments that will be posted online. It's also got a built-in XLR preamp, which allows you to hook up two different microphones and provide them with power. Now, there are some key, absolutely unbreakable commandments when it comes to the XA-10. First, always carry batteries. Make sure they're charged up and already attached to the camera so you can start shooting footage immediately. Second, don't cheap out on an SD card. Something like 32GB Class 10 will do fine for video and will allow you to record for several hours. Have an SD card that is dedicated solely for video work. Don't switch back and forth between different devices in the XA-10. They sometimes don't play well together. And finally, and perhaps most importantly, wear headphones. And I mean over-the-ear headphones like these. The reason why you need headphones is that you need to hear what you are recording. You have to pay attention to fans, vents, lights, traffic. All these affect the way you record audio. Your ears are perfectly tuned so that when I'm talking to you in person, you focus directly on my voice, and you won't hear all the other things going on in the background. But a microphone hears the entire spectrum. So headphones, batteries, and a dedicated SD card. There is no magic potion, no magic awesome button, no software solution, and no time machine that will fix bad recording practices. So take the extra few minutes to do things right, and you'll save yourself a huge amount of headaches. If you'd like to use an outside video camera, you are generally allowed to, but check with your professor first. As with all things, the same standards apply. So no excuses. Bad work is bad work, regardless if you shot up with the best cameras, lenses, and microphones available. So let's get started. For almost every shot you use in journalism, you should use a tripod. If you don't know how to set up a tripod, I have a video on that, and you can find a link to that right below the like and subscribe buttons of this video. After setting up the tripod, go ahead and slide the battery into the battery slot of the camera. Don't force it. Wait for a gentle click, and you'll be good to go. Then, attach the tripod plate to the bottom of the camera. If it has a lens arrow like this one does, point it in the direction of the lens. Next, put the camera onto the tripod. Make sure it's secure so that it won't fall. The next thing you'll need to do is put in your SD card. Slide open the gate gently and carefully place the SD card inside. There are two slots. Put it in slot A for now. Wait until you hear a gentle click. Now, let's set up the microphone. Select which windsock you need. I'm opting for the basic one, but you can use the heavy wind one if that suits your environment. Unscrew the top of the mic holder on the camera, and then carefully lay the microphone inside. Screw it gently so that it's tight and won't fall out. Next, grab the short XLR cable and plug in one end into the microphone and the other into the preamp on the camera. Use channel 1. We need to set up the options on the preamp. Make sure first that the external preamp is on. You do this by selecting EXT, short for external. If you use INT, that will use the internal microphone, which has terrible audio quality. Make sure for input 1 you set it to 48 volts. That's for phantom power and that's what powers the microphone. Next, set the attenuator to off. An attenuator is used to turn down a really noisy signal. So by using headphones, you can check on your noise levels. And if you find that you're distorting, go ahead and turn it on. As with all things production related, you'll have to adapt to the environment you're in. Next, use the dial wheel on the side of the camera to adjust the recording levels. Be sure to plug in your headphones first on the side of the camera so that way you can hear what's going on. Do this before you start recording, or you might ruin a great interview. If you're planning on using a wireless mic kit, use just mic. Because the wireless mic kits have batteries, the 48-volt phantom power will cause interference on the transmitter and will ruin the audio. If you're recording directly from a mixing board or a pool feed at a press conference, use line. Now let's go ahead and turn on the camera. You'll see that there's a switch that moves between auto, cinema, and manual. Set it to manual. auto-disable some of the key options we need for production work, and so does cinema. On the front of the camera, take out the lens cap and place it inside of your kit. You don't want to lose it. Let's go ahead and turn on the camera. On the right side, press the power button until the screen lights up. The first thing we're going to do is set up the exposure. Select Func at the top, that's short for function. Select Rec Programs. Your interface might look a little bit different than mine, that's okay. You just might need to hunt a little bit more for the settings. Inside of Rec Programs, select P for Programmed Auto Exposure. Now exit out of the submenu and select Func again. This time, choose White Balance. There are only two types of acceptable white balances, automatic and custom. Automatic, or AWB, is used for run and gun situations, like going from indoors to outdoors. If you're in a controlled environment, such as a sit-down interview, select the custom switches. Place a white piece of paper at least 6 inches away from the lens. Then, using the zoom controls at the top or on the side, zoom in on the paper. Then tap the custom button and the computer will figure it out and select the right Kelvin color temperature. I recommend leaving the camera on automatic because it does a pretty good job for almost all circumstances. We're going to need to set up some more options. So from heading from the main screen, tap on Func again and this time tap on menu. You should see a screen like mine with three tabs. Make sure you're in the first tab. Set the digital zoom to 200x, then hit the back button. Next, you'll need to change the autofocus mode to IAF, that's short for instant autofocus. Next, turn on the focus assistance, then turn on the face detection and tracking. Now, the computer is really good at detecting faces, and sometimes it's too good. It might detect paintings, photos, and other stuff like that. If it does, just tap on the screen onto the real faces and the computer will readjust. Next, turn on the auto backlight correction and auto slow shutter. Make sure the ND, or neutral density filter, is set to automatic. Finally, absolutely make sure the on-screen markers are set to grid gray. This will overlay a grid onto your image, allowing you to easily follow the rule of thirds. If you don't know what the rule of thirds is, there's a video on that, and you can check it out on this channel here. Now let's tap on the second tab, the one that looks like a small piece of film. Scroll down to Rec Media for Movies, and tap on that. Be sure to select the A slot for your SD card, even though the camera has built-in space to record your files. I find that it's often much faster to record to an SD card. Also, if you're sharing your camera with other people, like for example, in a journalism school, you want to keep your files separate from the camera. As well, make sure you have a separate SD card for each device. Like I said before, they sometimes don't play well together, and it helps to keep things organized. Let's head back out to the menu. Scroll one more down and select Recording Mode. Make sure it is set to MXP for the highest quality possible. Scroll one more down and select Frame Rate. And inside of the frame rate, select PF30 for 30 frames per second using a progressive frame rate. If you need to format your SD card because it's new or you want to get rid of old files on an old SD card, push the third tab and then scroll down and tap on Initialize SD. You'll have to confirm, and please be sure before confirming. Now let's push the X at the top right and exit out of the main interface. We need to adjust the image by zooming in and out of focus on objects or people we want in our frame. Using either controls on the side or on the top, we can zoom in or out using the W and T. The one on the top is a fine zoom, so it goes more slowly, while the side zoom is much quicker. To record, push the red recording button on the top or the side. Go ahead, introduce yourself. Now let's hit that record button once more to stop recording. To review the footage that has been recorded, tap the button located on the top left of the inside of the LCD panel. Then, using the touchscreen, you can tap on the clip to play it back. Now let's go ahead and end off with some tips for success. The first thing is practice. No one is a naturally gifted videographer. It takes time to develop, and the best way to develop is by practicing. So take out the camera, practice around, practice with your family, your pets, get them a little bit annoyed, but have an idea of how the camera works. Always use headphones when recording. This way, you'll be sure that you're not getting bad audio. People often forget that visual quality isn't everything. Video is two parts, visual and audio, so don't neglect one for the other. Next, make sure you white balance for every shot. You can use the automatic white balance so you don't have to worry about this, but I recommend custom white balances in controlled situations. And finally, use a tripod for every shot. Thanks for watching, and I hope to catch you guys in the next one.